Hare Krishna. Effective speech is characterized not just by correctness, but also by appropriateness. When we speak, especially when we are to speak as leaders to inspire and motivate others to do certain things, then we need to tap the power of speech effectively. And even if we are not officially in leadership positions, when we are interacting with each other, we want our speech to be effective. And the Bhagavad Gita in its 17th chapter gives some guidelines for austerity of speech, which is what will make our speech effective. It says in 17.15, Anudvega karam vakyam satyam priyahitam chayat svadhyayabhyasanam chaiva vanmayam tapa uchyate. It says Anudvega karam vakyam. Let's speak in a way that does not agitate people's minds. And satyam, speak that which is truthful. Priyam, speak that which is pleasing. Hitam, speak that which is beneficial, and speak that which is scriptural. Svadhyayabhyasanam chaiva. All this is vanmayam tapa uchyate. All this is austerity of speech. So here, Krishna starts this characterization by saying, anudvegakaram. Don't speak things which are agitating. So sometimes we may want to speak a particular truth, and I am correct in making this point. Yes. Our speech may be characterized by correctness, but sometimes correctness can alienate people. People are not just robots who are programmed to do the right thing, and if they're wrong thing, they do the wrong thing, the programming points it out. It's a wrong programming. Actually, people are conscious beings, they have feelings. And even when somebody has done something wrong and we want them to do the right thing, our speech should not just be enlightening, telling them what is the right thing to do, but it should also be encouraging. Encouraging means that we need to be able to give them the inspiration, the motivation, the hope, the confidence that yes, you can do the right thing. That's why if we agitate people so much that they become disheartened, they become demotivated, and they no longer feel like doing the right thing, then our speech may be correct in its content, but it will be incorrect in its consequence. Effective speech is speech that is not only correct in its content, but it's correct in its consequence. And therefore, we need to see whether, when we are correcting someone, whether we are in the right position and the right disposition to do that. Do we have the authority to correct that person? Do we have the mood of service? Does this person have that relationship with me by which they can take my feedback constructively? When we consider all these factors, then that is the consideration of appropriateness. And when our speech is appropriate, we will not only be able to correct people when they are wrong, but also we'll be able to encourage and inspire them to do better when they have done the right thing. And thus our speech will become effective and transformational when we focus not just on correctness but also on appropriateness. Thank you. Hare Krishna.